In this video, we are going to discuss about the first classification of systems. So, that is linear and nonlinear systems. So, here linear system is a system which satisfies the superposition principle and linearity, and at the same time the nonlinear system is a system which does not satisfy the superposition principle. That means it violates the superposition principle. Now, you can see the definition. A system is said to be linear if it satisfies the superposition principle and generally a linearity also. Consider a system with inputs x1 of t and x2 of t and output y1 of t and y2 of t. So, that means consider a system. So, if you give an x1 of t, it will provide y1 of t as output, and if you provide x1 of t, it will provide y2 of t as output. So, if you want to say that system is linear, then that system need to satisfy this relation. That means transform of combined signal must be is equal into addition of transform of individual signals. So, that means, so if you are having a system like this, if you are having any system like this, this is a system with input x1 of t and x2 of t. So, here we are giving two signals and we are giving, getting two different outputs. This is your system. So, this is having some response. Actually, this may be a squaring circuit, this may be a differentiator, this may be an integrator or any system. This is any system with a particular response. If you are giving x1 of t, then you are going to get y1 of t. If you are giving x2 of t, then whatever response we are getting, that I am considering as y2 of t. Now, to say this system is linear, then you need to satisfy this condition. That means, for example, first of all you need to give x1 of t and you need to observe the output, and second time after getting the response of first signal, you need to give x2 of t and you need to get y2 of t. Finally, you need to combine the responses. So, that must be equal to. So, at the time of input itself, you need to combine two signals like this and you need to provide the output that must be equal to the previous added output. So, here, so if this system satisfied that condition, so particularly that is said to be a linear system. To explain clearly, I am going to consider an example. So, here for example, this is a system with the response y of t is equal into x square of t. Treat this system is a squaring system. That means, whatever signal we are giving to the system, this is going to square that signal and giving output. So, now I want to consider, I want to proceed individually. After that, I want to combine the signal and I want to give as input. So, first of all, for this system, I want to provide only x1 of t. That means, t indicates, so transfer the signal or response, you can consider like anything. So, I want to consider this as, so when this signal is transformed through that system. So, like that I am going to consider here. So, if you consider x1 of t first, then transform of x1 of t will become x1 square of t. Why? Because whatever we are giving, the system work is just to square. Why? Because they given, in exam they will give. If a system with response y of t is equal to x square of t, then the system is linear or non-linear. They will ask like that. So, now according to the system response, whatever signal we are transforming from that system, that is going to square. So, x1 square of t will come as output. When you transformed your second signal x2 of t through this system, again this system, what this system will do, generally whatever signal it is getting, it is going to square that signal. So, you are going to get x square of t. Then, third thing what we need to do, initially we need to combine the signal and you need to provide the output. So, you can see this is an individual output. If you consider linearity, so you can consider a1 x1 square of t plus a2 x2 square of t will be your right side part. So why? Because transform of x1 of t is x1 square of t, transform of x2 of t is x2 square of t. So this will become like this for this system with response y of t equal to x square of t. So now I want to check my LHS, that means combined signal input. So here if you transformed the combined signal, that means a1 x1 of t plus a2 x2 of t, then what system will do? System will do just a squaring. Why? Because they given that is a squaring system which squares the input waveform. It don't want what signal we are getting, that is a combined signal, that is a individual signal, which whatever the signal that system is getting, that is going to square. So here that system, what signal we want to transmit through that system, the combined signal. So system don't want that is a combined signal or individual, it's going to square whatever it's getting as input. So now x1 of t plus a2 x2 of t is going to square whatever we are giving in this transform. So whatever we are having in the brackets, that means, so that indicates that is we are giving to the system. So that system is going to square. So you can imagine these two are equal. So you can say these two are equal. No, we can't say these two are equal, because this is just a1 x1 square of t plus a2 x2 square of t. But here, so a1 x1 of t plus a2 x2 of t whole square means, so a1 x1 of t plus a2 x2 of t square will come, but plus 2ab part, so that 2ab part, so we are not going to get. So here these two are not equal, that means it's violating superposition principle. That means this is a individual response, this is a individual response, but here this is common response. So common signal response. So here, as individual response is not equal to common response, so it's violating superposition principle. So we can say the system with this response is a nonlinear system. This is a nonlinear system. This is a nonlinear system. For example, if you are having any system with y of t is equivalent to x of t. So this you just treat like a buffer. For example, you are having a system only with a buffer. It may have some delay, but whatever signal we are giving, it's processing as usual. That means y of t equal to x of t is the response of a system. The response indicates whatever signal we are giving, same thing we are getting as an output. That is the meaning of y of t is equivalent to x of t. So now for this type of system, so that is a linear system or non-linear if you want to check, then for example, if you given, I want to check that, so you can see. So first of all, what we need to check means, we need to check whether the individual is equivalent to common signal. That means I want to check transform of x1 of t. So here transform of x1 of t signal through the system with this response will become x1 of t only. Why? Because now in this case our system is going to process the signal without any change. But in case of last system we consider, so that is squaring. But here system is not doing anything, just processing whatever it's getting as input, it's just processing to the response or output. So if we give an x1 of t, if you want to transform this signal to the through the system, then the system is giving x1 of t only, it's not going to change anything. So now if you want to give x2 of t also, it's going to get x2 of t only. So if you consider the left part of your superposition theorem, so this is equivalent to total response of system for these two signals is equivalent to a1 x1 of t plus a2 x2 of t. So similarly, for example, if you consider the combined signal, that means a1 x1 of t plus a2 x2 of t, if you consider the combined signal with some amplitudes like this, then here also system don't want whether we are giving combined signal or anything. So whatever we are giving to transform through that system, so according to our system response, it's going to process. So now our system is going to process whatever we are giving, same thing it's going to process it to the output. So now here, so output is as same as we are giving. So that is equivalent to A1 X1 of T plus A2 X2 of T. So you can see, so this is individual response, that means combining of these two with amplitudes, and this is common response after combining signal, that means before giving as input we are combining, here individually we are giving, and after getting response, responses we are combining. So these two are equal. So that means these signal, this system with this response satisfied the superposition principle and said to be a linear system. So this not non-linear, this is a linear system. So this systems like this are non-linear. Like this way we need to check whether the systems are linear or non-linear. And I want to give you a shortcut point to trace the system is a linear or non-linear, means most of the systems with the square are not linear. That means most of the systems with the response included squares may be non-linear systems. So definitely by observing the response itself, you can say whether the system is linear or non-linear. This is about linear and non-linear systems. This is very important for gate point of view. In the next class, we will discuss some problems related to this.